Roadrunner Rundown on Bakersfield.com and the CSUB Roadrunners Digital Network. Downtown Bakersfield, California.
Driving Harrington for the win! Yes! CSUB Roadrunners are your Western Athletic Conference baseball champions!
Here's the voice of the runners, Corey Costello.
Hey, happy Thanksgiving week, and welcome once again to Roadrunner Rundown, the official program, CSUB Roadrunner Athletics. I'm Corey Costello. Thanks so much for joining us once again on the show. We got a good one planned for you today as we sort of continue as a transition into the winter season of sport, and we'll be talking with head volleyball coach Giovana Melo. The runners coming off their third consecutive trip to the WAC championship game in the WAC tournament. The runners coming up short in that one, but still a great season for CSUB. We'll talk about that a little bit, and more importantly, Coach Melo has a really cool coaching clinic coming up December the 11th or the 13th at the Icardo Center. So all you volleyball coaches and maybe soon-to-be volleyball coaches, up-and-coming volleyball coaches, you got a chance to learn from some really good coaches, including Coach Melo, along with a couple USA Volleyball members as well. So really a cool opportunity to check out some of the finer points of volleyball coaching. And we'll talk more about that coming up in the next segment of the program. Also coming up at the bottom of the hour, head baseball coach Bob Macaluso will join us. Roadrunners just releasing their 2016 schedule, and on top of that, they've also have a pretty good signing class from last week's early signing period, so we'll chat with him about his recruiting class for the 2017 season, and much more as well for the Roadrunners, who also just wrapped up the fall portion of their season, which if you follow college baseball, it's a very important part of the year, because a lot of the starting spots and starting lineup spots and all that good stuff are decided in the fall, because you don't have a lot of time between your winter practices or when your practice starts in the new year and your first game, which is always in February. So we'll speak with Coach Macaluso about kind of recapping the fall and talk about the schedule and all that good stuff as well. And then speaking of CSUB baseball, really cool guest going to join us in the final segment of the program, Mickey Jannis. He is a Roadrunner graduate from 2010. He was drafted by the Tampa Bay Rays, has a great story. He played a couple years in the minors, got released, then he reinvented himself as a knuckleball pitcher, and he went on to play a few years in the independent leagues, was signed this past year by the New York Mets once again, and just got done playing in the Arizona Fall League with the New York Mets and had a tremendous outing, so much so during the Fall League that MLB.com kind of called him the next up-and-coming knuckleballer. So we'll speak with Mickey Jannis about that as well. Great story from a former Roadrunner, and a lot of stuff to get to on today's program. So a lot of guests coming up, but also we got a lot of highlights to get to, so let's roll them right now for CSUB. We'll start with men's basketball. Runners had two games last week, and first of which being their game against Fresno Pacific, and Ali Ahmed, two of his 18 early, and then Damian Durham letting loose in this one from way outside. He would score 16 for the Runners. More Ahmed in the post, and Idaho, not a problem for him despite having a pretty good defense down low. Then the jump hook and the putback for Ali Ahmed as well as he gets rolling. Then Kevin Mays gets rolling as well. He hits the mid-range. CSUB's lead is 10, just 9 minutes in. And then speaking of Mays, how about his first three-pointer of his career from downtown? Runners in control. Speaking of threes, more from Durham from the Idaho bench. This one goes in. He just starts to heat up with three first-half three-pointers. Number five doesn't go, but how about that putback dunk? Let's watch it again. Justin Hollins cleaning up the glass for the Roadrunners. Runners by 15, and great timing as well here as Durham is going to get another three. How are you going to defend that? He's shooting from the parking lot. Then Hollins continues as Runners post dominance with another jam off the Brent Rapp assist, and then Durham shooting from Shafter, connecting once again. Runners by 12 at the break. Second half, more Ahmed, the offensive rebound, and the putback. We saw Kevin Mays with his first three. How about Brent Rapp? First of his career, Runners by 17. Speaking of threes, Durham, and that is not an easy shot. He makes it look easy. Runners start to pull away in the second half. Ahmed capping off a night with his 18th point here, and then Diedrich Basel going to keep rolling as the Runners dominate Idaho in their first of two games last week, and the Runners win it handily 68-245. So they beat their former Western Athletic Conference foe by 23 points, including forcing 20 turnovers in the victory. Then the Runners went on to Friday afternoon and hosted Fresno Pacific, special a noontime start, and didn't really hurt the Runners' offense. They score 81 points. They win 81-68. Kevin Mays, 29 points. That's a career high, 13 rebounds, as well in the victory. Here's what's coming up for the runners, who are 3-0 for the first time in a decade. They will go to Wyoming a Wednesday before Thanksgiving as they take on the Cowboys. 7 o'clock Mountain Time is the tip-off on that one. And then the Roadrunners this Sunday will be at St. Mary's, a 5 o'clock start. The Gales off to a 4-0 start on the season as well. To CSUB women's basketball, they had a rough couple first games, but trying to return and reverse that on Sunday at the Icardo Center. And early on, Badabe Zampari, career day, 24 points, 22 rebounds. Wasn't that easy all game, though, as San Jose State led most of the contest. Nyree Harris with two of her 17. Then the runners gave up a steal and a basket there. Then a steal by Ania Baker. And the layup, San Jose State led by 12 with a minute and a half to play. But cue the comeback. Runners going to work. They missed the three here, but that means offensive rebound and put back for Erica Williams. It's a 9-point game after her free throw. 29 seconds to go. Make it four as Zampari gets the layup. Alexis Gilbert with the steal and layup. It's a 2-point game with 25 seconds left. After a San Jose State miss, the runners looking to tie who else but Zampari. Down low, she ties the game with 8 seconds to go. Chance for the Spartans here, but it's stolen away. Haley Ford, a chance for the buzzer beater. She spots up this ball. In and out, not going to go, and so we will head to overtime. San Jose State builds a 6-point lead as one more look at the Haley Ford steal and got a great look at the game winner, and it goes about halfway down and comes back out. San Jose State, though, going to build a 6-point lead off the bank in overtime, but CSUB still goes to work. Addie Walters cuts the lead to 4 with this floater, then Walters with the miss. But a nice defensive play here for the Roadrunners. They force the turnover off the rebound. And then they're going to go to Badabe Zampari. First off, the miss and the rebound. And then the 3-point play off the inbound here from Erica Williams. Lead is 1 for San Jose State. But make it Harris for another 3 as it's a 4-point lead with 1:48 to play. Then Gilbert with a good day. She made it better with this drive and foul. She hits both to make it a 1-point game. Another costly turnover for the Spartans, who pick up the violation. Back to CSUB, down by 1. Who else but Badabe Zampari fouled. And she's going to make both again. CSUB up by a point. Spartans back on the attack. This one doesn't fall. Tied up ball. Arrow to CSUB. Spartans will foul Addie Walters right away. She's going to hit them both. And runners have a 3-point lead, 12 seconds to go. Runners wisely foul to avoid giving up the game tying shot. So Baker, she's going to make them both. The runners will get fouled as Alyssa Shannon misses the first. She'll make the second to put Bakersfield up by 2. Last second effort for the Spartans, going to come up short. The Roadrunners completing the comeback, outscoring San Jose State 12-0 over the final minute and a half of regulation to force overtime, and they win it in OT 88-86 as Badabe Zampari, 24 points, 22 rebounds in the victory. She is also the WAC Player of the Week for that effort, an impressive first win for the Roadrunners. It's going to get very tough, though, for Bakersfield coming up. Here's what they got happening. They're going to go to the Hawaii tournament coming up over Thanksgiving weekend. Runners will take on host Hawaii Friday at 2 o'clock Pacific time. Then they're going to take on number 2 in the nation, South Carolina. That's Saturday at 10:30 a.m. Pacific. And then they will cap the tournament against number 18 ranked Arizona State Sunday at 11:30. So a very tough upcoming stretch for CSUB women's basketball, who enters at 1-2 on the season. On to CSUB volleyball. As we alluded to earlier, the runners making their third straight WAC Championship Final, second under head coach Giovana Melo, but unfortunately they lose this one to New Mexico State, who went unbeaten in WAC play, 3-0. Runners were close in a couple of the games, but the Aggies able to pull away. Kelsey Sawyer and Louisa Martins were named to the all-tournament team. Big night for CSUB wrestling last Friday night as the Roadrunners got a chance to host someone special. Yeah, number 1 Penn State, that's going to draw a crowd at the Icardo Center. How about that group? And why not? Because, well, there's wrestling royalty in the house. That's Cale Sanderson, wrestling legend, 159-0, gold medalist, you name it. All Penn State in this one, though, 141 pounds, 5th-ranked James Goulibon versus Ian Nickel, and Penn State so quick in this one, just like that, the ankle pick, and he would stick it and get the double leg as well, 2-point takedown for the early lead. Goulibon, more of the same in the second period. He takes a single leg, another takedown. He remains unbeaten, beating Nickel 8-1 in this one as Penn State out to the early lead in the duel. 149 pounds, second-ranked James Relaford, and Coleman Hammond, first period. It's going to be Coleman Hammond. He gets caught exposing his back. Relaford doesn't look back. He keeps control for the pin, and it's the first of the evening for the Nittany Lions. Rough night for the Hammond brothers in general. Big brother Bryce here at 174, taking on sixth-ranked Bo Nickel. Hammond ranked 16th, but Bryce tries one of his signature rolls, and watch it coming up right here. gets caught halfway through. Nickel able to hold on. He's going to pin Bryce Hammond, which doesn't happen very often. Hammond cannot believe it there. He said afterwards he was still trying to figure out how it went so bad so quickly. He still wasn't sure what happened as Nickel gets the pinfall. 197 pounds. And how about number one, Morgan McIntosh taking on a very game Reuben Franklin, who gave him a go. McIntosh off the tie-up early for the single leg takedown and the lead. Franklin would manage, though, however, to come up right here with the one-point escape to keep it close in the first period. Second period, Franklin on the verge of CSUB's first takedown of the duel. Look at McIntosh's athleticism. He's going to do the splits right here to avoid the takedown, but Franklin, yikes. Franklin's going to continue to work up the leg and eventually comes up with the takedown for the Roadrunners. Third period, it gets interesting as Franklin puts McIntosh in a tough spot as look at Franklin almost able to post and almost turning McIntosh to his back for the near fall, but he's not going to quite get there as here's another look from down low. Franklin really trying to get something happening, but McIntosh too strong and able to force back to neutral. And after that, later in the period, another takedown for McIntosh. He remains unbeaten with a 13-5 victory over Reuben Franklin. On to heavyweight, the runner's best chance for a win, and Matt Williams not disappointing for the Roadrunners as he takes an early control over Jan Johnson of Penn State, a sophomore and a freshman wrestling here. And this is going to be interesting. Watch this coming up. Johnson on the bottom, and referee right there ordering a stall point to Williams for Johnson stalling, and then it's going to happen again as Williams has control down low. Referee watching Johnson underneath, doesn't like his inactivity on the bottom. As there is another stall point awarded to Williams. He gets the 2-0 lead. Second period, and then we go to the third period as there's a one-point escape, 3-0 win coming for Matt Williams. The one win for Bakersfield in this duel, but Williams happy in front of a large crowd, over 1,900 at the Carter Center for this one. And Williams celebrates the runner's lone victory, but Bakersfield does fall to top-ranked Penn State 39-3. In this duel as Williams picks up the win for the Roadrunners. And on to the next slate for the Roadrunners. It's going to be a tough go for them as well. They're going to go to the Cliff Keen Invitational in Las Vegas. Some of the best wrestlers in the nation involved in this one, December 4th and 5th in Las Vegas, as Bakersfield sends some of their top guys to one of the best tournaments in the country. So really a exciting week for CSUB Wrestling, hosting number one Penn State, and probably could have got a couple more matches, but the Nittany Lions, as advertised, very good, number one of the country, and dominating in a lot of aspects. But a good showing and a good showing of support for CSUB Wrestling as well with their duel against Penn State at the Carter Center this past week. So again, they'll be at the Cliff Keen Invitational next week in Las Vegas. All right, we're going to step away and take a break. When we come back, we're going to speak with volleyball head coach Giovana Melo as we kind of recap the 2015 season and preview for the for her a really cool coaches clinic coming up in middle December at the Carter Center. A chance for you you aspiring or current volleyball coaches to learn from some of the best. We'll talk about that next. When we get back, this is Roadrunner Rundown.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to learning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, anyplace. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
Thursdays at 10 a.m. on Bakersfield.com, you'll find your favorite pair on the air. Don Clark and Tina Miller host Open Up, a show devoted to getting inside the real stories about real people. From community leaders to small businesses, Open Up is your forum to tell it like it is. It's Open Up with Don and Tina.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Roadrunners basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSUB basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE. And welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. Still to come on the program, Bob Macaluso going to join us. Bottom of the hour, CSUB baseball coach. We'll chat about his schedule coming out. A couple of other things coming up for Coach Macaluso. And the baseball team's got done with the fall portion of their season, getting ready for their 2016 year to open up in February. And also Mickey Jannis will join us on the program, former Roadrunner now in the Mets organization. Had a really good Arizona Fall League. We'll talk with him about that as he reinvents himself as a knuckleballer. But first, we want to welcome to the program, because she's always practicing during this time of year during the show, and we can never really catch up with her. But it's nice to have her once in a while. Head coach Giovana Melo, CSUB Volleyball. Good to see you again. How are you?
You too. I'm good.
Well, congratulations again on what was the program's third straight, your second straight appearance in the WAC tournament finals. I know it was a tough loss to New Mexico State, but they're a pretty good team.
Yeah, they were. They were pretty solid. But, you know, I was happy with our Andy.
Yeah, I mean, you guys, again, had a really good – you got the 2 seed, you got a bye, then you had a – you played very well against UTRGV, yes. A team that you'd split with on the year. So, obviously, it wasn't a completely lost tournament. You guys played pretty well.
No, yeah, we did. We did, yeah. I was happy. The girls, you know, kept fighting, had a lot of heart, and was happy for sure.
Yeah, now you get to go to the task of having to replace stuff for next year. I know, as a coach, a great setter, Louisa Martins, a couple outside hitters. You got a few players maybe on the roster that can step up, or are you kind of bringing in new recruits for those roles?
I think a little bit of both. We'll have some players step up and trying to bring some to replace them for sure.
What's kind of, as you coaches sort of transition into the off season, what is kind of the off season goals for the program as you prepare for next year?
You know, it's definitely recruiting and spending some time getting them better and prepared for the following season. But they also play sand, so it's, you know, it's hard for us to train them a lot in indoor because they're doing sand, and we don't want to overdo it and get them, you know, hurt or anything like that. So it's a little bit of both things, getting them in a court when we can, and then a lot of recruiting.
And then but that sand, I mean, it seems to help. I mean, it helps to have players stay in game shape and stay conditioned and then play another form of volleyball.
Yeah, I mean, our players that have been playing sand have gotten tons better, and you can see it. And so we're excited for the sand season, excited for them too. For some of them that've never done it, you know, we have a lot of new players that are going to experience for the first time, so we're excited to see what we can do in the sand as well.
Awesome. Now let's talk about this coaching clinic, gold medal squared, coming up December 11th to the 13th at the Icardo Center. And first of all, what's the sort of gold medal squared approach about?
It's, you know, it's a system that it's ran by a lot of universities. Carl, the guy who is coming in here, is the one who started the system. And so he's put a lot of things together to get the system where it is now. But a lot of big schools are running the system. We run the system. And that's what the clinic is all about, just teaching the fundamentals and the way we run the system and why we do things the way we do it. Because a lot of it and everything that Gold Medal Square does is all about the statistics, and it's proven, you know, that it has worked for a lot of people.
Does that help you as a coach with a team that is usually historically a little smaller than some of the other? Does this system kind of help offset some of that maybe size difference you're giving up on the floor?
Yeah, it does for sure. It's a system designed in a way that you can play a little bit faster. You should be pretty good on defense, and so that's what we have been doing, and it has helped us. It has helped me as a head coach, and so I'm fully committed to it.
Awesome. You got some special guests. You brought up Carl McGowan, who's the Hall of Fame coach and founding member of Gold Medal Squared, and then Mike Wall from USA Volleyball. Talk about those two a little bit.
Yeah, they're tremendous coaches. You know, I think that if people come and listen to them talk, as I have done and I've learned from them, they will see that it what they do and what they believe in works. You know, Mike is with the USA Men's, and they're very successful. Carl has so much to offer as a Hall of Famer, but he was also in the, coaching Olympic teams. And so I worked with Mike myself when I was at Arizona State and learned a lot from him personally. And just by doing the system and learning the system with Carl, I've gotten a lot of contacts with him as well. So it's two great coaches that are going to be here to teach, you know, the system and teach volleyball. It's a fun atmosphere to be at, just learning from each other. Also, just getting to know coaches, you know, it's what it's all about.
Now, who's this kind of geared towards? I mean, we're talking high school coaches, club coaches, youth coaches, a little bit of everybody, right?
Everybody. It's for every single aspect. And that's why the system is successful, because there's so many high school programs that have done the system and won championships, college winning championships, obviously the national team winning gold medals. And so it works for everybody, and women, men, it doesn't matter. That's how the system is designed to help everybody.
Do you know any like off the top of your head here locally that run it off the top of your head?
Or? To be honest, I haven't seen it, least from the high schools that I have seen, the clubs. Not many of them run the system. Maybe they pick up a few things from the system, but not necessarily the full system. And so I think it's something that they can help.
Yeah, what's kind of the baseline? What's like really the basis of the system that would that would benefit teams?
We swing block, which for the little bit shorter players, help them jump a little bit higher. Mm-hmm. You know, do a few more things that they wouldn't be doing if they were not swing blocking. The way we position ourselves when we're passing with our arms, with our hands, the way the system defensively is designed is to put the best people in the position where the ball goes the most. So we call it, putting our libero in middle, which is where most of the ball goes. And if you watch a game, you see how many balls go in the middle of the court. And for high school, that's huge because, if you put your best people where most of the ball goes, the tendency is for you to be very successful. And so it's a little bit of the system, kind of how we run, but there's so much more and so many more details that they can learn coming in through that coaching clinic.
Awesome. How did it come about that you got a chance to host it on campus?
You know, I have been begging them to do it for a long time, and winning the WAC, I think it helped. I said, there's so many coaches and there's so many high schools around here, and I think it would be great for us to host. I mean, we have LAX right next to us. Yeah. Bakersfield has an airport. We can bring not just local coaches, but other coaches from all over the place. And I have been just pushing them, and they finally said, okay, G, we'll do it. So here they are.
December 11th to the 13th at the Icardo Center. Goldmedalsquared.com is the website. Is that where folks coaches can register?
Yes, that's it. We have to go through them to get registered. Okay. But if they contact me, I can direct them to the right people as well.
Awesome. Awesome. It seems like, I was thinking about this over the weekend, and I know you were out of town and kind of focused on what was happening with the team, but, they had the high school volleyball championships in the Valley this past weekend up in Lemoore, and I don't know, we had like five teams winning championships, and then you guys were in the finals again, won the championship last year. It's kind of interesting to see really how volleyball has sort of, grown mm-hmm. in this community in the last 4 years or so. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've got really top-notch talent, and obviously we're seeing a lot of success at the high school levels now.
Yeah, it was one of the biggest things for me when I got a job. I started going around and seeing how much talent there is here. Yeah. I mean, it's awesome. And I think, you know, I've been trying to push something like this here because not just for the system on itself, but learning from other coaches and getting to know other coaches. I think that's very important. You know, sometimes there's so many coaches around here that you don't get to know well. Yeah. I mean, you know of them, but you don't get to know them. And this is a great, you know, time to get to know each other, you know, learn why they do things that way and talk about the talent that there is as well. You know, maybe you don't, even if you don't believe completely in the system, you can pick up a few things sure. that can help your team tremendously in, you know, in a year or so.
Yeah, awesome. And you know, you had a couple locals on your roster this mm-hmm. year, and I know one of those talented ones was Aditza, who mm-hmm. went somewhere else first and then came mm-hmm. back here. Are you getting more and more, especially as the talent level increases in the mm-hmm. Kern County area, more and more players looking at CSUB to stay local potentially?
I think so, and that's our goal. We've had a little bit of both. Players that are coming back and players that, you know, kind of want to get out to see what there yeah. is, you know, outside of here, but then they come back because of, you know, the talent is great here. And I think the better we are, we continue to grow as a program and get a little bit better, the more we're going to get those local kids wanting to stay. Because, I mean, if you look at Bakersfield in the community, it's a very family-oriented. Yeah. And I think that a lot of them want to stay. They just wanted to, you know, be competitive.
And it's got to be hard, too. I mean, I understood it. I mean, not as an athlete, but just as a college student. When I got mm-hmm. out of high school, I'm thinking, I want to go, you know, I'd like to go somewhere mm-hmm. out. So yeah. it's got to be hard and a challenge for you coaches in any mm-hmm. sport mm-hmm. when I know a lot of people will a lot of times say, well, they got so much talent in the area. How come we just can't recruit mm-hmm. those kids? Well, sometimes they want to go mm-hmm. out and try something
yeah.
different.
Yeah, and that has been a little bit of what we have faced. And we've been able to get a few, but, you know, the great athletes right now are not wanting to come, you know, to stay and right. wanting to kind of explore a little bit more. And we're suffer with that, but we're hoping to change that.
And you bring in plenty of talent from Brazil, so that
yes,
helps.
That's right.
what was your early signing period like, and what do you think about your recruiting class for next year?
You know, we were able to get two kids, one of them from Bakersfield, and I think that we have a good chance with some kids that, you know, a couple international kids and doing the same thing that we did last year. But we're trying to maybe go towards bringing more freshmen to grow because we were able to fill in that gap that yeah. we had because of that. You know, a system, for example, like that kids are here for 2 years, they start learning the system and they have to go. And that's not something that, you know, we want to do. Yeah. And we want to bring kids a little bit early and bring kids that can grow in a system and become better. And so I think that we will have a pretty good recruiting class if we can get some of those kids that we're fighting for.
You know what I love about this system is I love seeing teams, like I mentioned before, that might have a little more size, mm-hmm. just be so confused on what is happening and why they can't seem to, yeah. you know, hit past the block mm-hmm. or hit through the block or why we continue to get points off their blocks. And it's just, there was one team this year, I can't remember who it was, but it might have been Seattle, and we won mm-hmm. it pretty handily. Mm-hmm. And as I'm walking out, someone said, you know, that team looked like we didn't belong. Mm-hmm. You know, we shouldn't have been mm-hmm. in the same gym as them yeah. based on their size difference. Mm-hmm. But, you know, we won it 3-0. I mean, yes. it seems like sometimes it creates problems for the coaches on the other side as well.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, a big example is when we played Stanford last year. You know, nobody gave us they're going to compete right. against this team. And they were 3-4 times bigger than we were. But, you know, we had Mariah being very disciplined and staying middle the entire time, and how many digs she had that game. You know, it's what it's all about. It's what yeah. the system is all about. And having players there biting into the system as well, you know, and understanding why we do the things we do it.
Right.
And then we can compete against anybody if we have the disciplined players that are willing to do what it takes to be good in that system.
Yeah, and you know, you brought up the libero, but I mean, what a great year that Sophie Fleming mm-hmm. had for you yes. guys in this. And she kind of, I know you had injuries, so she kind of had to take up the libero position. Yes. Like she'd been playing it her entire life. No. I mean, and she, you know, she'll be back again, right? So yeah. you have it for one more year.
Yes, I'm excited about her. You know, I've been telling her that I wanted to train her as a libero, but many things have been happening, yeah. and you know, she had to set in the beginning of the season, and then all of a sudden she is a libero, and I thought she did a tremendous job, and I'm excited to have her one more year.
There were balls that were hit near her that there was no she had no business even coming up with a dig, and she throws an arm out and dives and comes up with it. I mean, we had a couple times she was in the seats, you know, she's in the bench, making passes. I mean, some of her, she created so many points for your team this year, and it was really fun to watch.
Yeah, she definitely did.
Awesome. Well, a lot of that goes to the system, and a lot of that is because of good coaching as well. So congratulations on that. And again, I mean, congrats. I know it sucks losing in the finals, but you were there again.
Yes.
And the fact that CSUB's been there 3 years in a row is awesome with a championship to boot. So good luck. We'll try to make it four next year and two championships in 3 years. How
about that? That's right.
All right. Once again, December 11th through the 13th, Gold Medal Squared, the website goldmedalsquared.com for people that want to register for that. You can call Coach Mello at CSUB and she'll hook you up as well.
That's right.
All right, Coach. Good to see you.
Thank you.
All right.
Too.
We'll be right back, folks. When we come back, Bob Macaluso going to join us, head baseball coach. Runners released their schedule. They had a recruiting class and they just wrapped up fall ball. A lot of stuff to talk about. We'll be back after this. It's Roadrunner Rundown.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to winning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, anyplace. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
Thursdays at 10 a.m. on Bakersfield.com, you'll find your favorite pair on the air. Don Clark and Tina Miller host Open Up, a show devoted to getting inside the real stories about real people. From community leaders to small businesses, Open Up is your forum to tell it like it is. It's Open Up with Don and Tina.
Introducing TBC Mobile from the Bakersfield, California. The most complete news, sports, weather, video, opinion, and lifestyle coverage in Bakersfield and Kern County. It's the easiest way to stay up to date on all things local while on the go. Read it on your smartphone or tablet. Download now by searching Bakersfield, California in the Apple, Google, and Amazon app stores.
Roadrunners basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSUB basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to GoRunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
And welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. My thanks to Giovana Melo for joining us last segment, Director of Volleyball for CSUB. Again, the gold medal squared Coaches Clinic, goldmedalsquare.com. You can register for that December 11th to the 13th at the Icardo Center. So volleyball coaches, aspiring coaches, current coaches, learn what makes the runners so successful, because that program, I'm telling you, you'll take a team that sometimes you look like they're four times as tall as CSUB and the runners beat them in three sets and you're wondering why. It's the system. You can learn about it coming up in December at the Icardo Center. Joined now by CSUB head coach Bob Macaluso. The runners coming off their fall season is in the books. Important time of year. I know a lot of folks consider college baseball season starts in February, but the fall is when you guys determine a lot of stuff, don't you?
Yes, the fall is a critical time period for all Division I schools and other divisions for that matter. You know, it gets the new guys acclimated to the system. We get to throw in all our game plan in terms of defense and offense and bunt system. And it's just a really important period of time to develop.
Yeah.
Then you can also experiment with some players, and Bakersfield having players that are so versatile, that's exactly what we did. That was kind of the goal this fall, was to move players around and see exactly where they can best help the Roadrunners play next spring, because we had the loss of Miles Jones at shortstop,
right.
So that's kind of a big need to fill. And we had some infielders coming back. David Metzger, for me, one of the top second basemen on the West Coast, he can play shortstop. He has the arm to play shortstop. Miles' brother has somewhat emerged as the front runner shortstop. We'll keep that between me and you, Corey. Malik, it played shortstop all summer out in the Alaskan League,
okay.
A very good summer league,
yeah,
out in Alaska, and did well. So he came in and worked out. And Ryan Grochon played shortstop all summer up in Canada, up in a really good summer collegiate league, mm-hmm, up there. So all three played shortstop. We had them competing for that shortstop position. And for me, they all did well. They all did well. There's no question about it. That Malik kind of emerged towards the end of the fall to be kind of the front runner guy. Now, that doesn't mean he's going to start at all, but it was very interesting to see those three get after it. So we had some competition there. We certainly miss Miles, but I think we'll have some guys to play shortstop. And then, you know, obviously take a look at some of the new arms that you have on the mound, and we're going to have new catching. We had four new catchers.
Wow.
So it was exciting. So we had some new guys competing for positions all over the field.
And you had some guys last year, you know, the Christian Deatons and the Cody Whites and the guys that didn't see a ton of time, but they saw quality time when they were in the game, and those guys are versatile and guys you probably expect to see in the lineup a lot this year.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, Cody White's another guy there that I was talking about, versatility. We had him playing at first, third. He actually, I call it experiment off the mound, but we put him on the mound, and he worked on the mound, and he did really well.
Okay.
You laugh. He has a really good arm. He was 88 to 91 with a good slider, a good changeup, and he is a good catcher. So, you know, he presents a pretty good dilemma there for the coaching staff. And then Christian Deaton, an offensive player, he needs some work on defense and did work and worked hard and improved his defense out in left field and center. And we hope that he will have a positive impact on the team as well this spring.
I'm hoping at one point, if Cody White can pitch and he can also catch, maybe at one point we can do the old Little League switch where he's catching and then you come out and then he's got to take the gear off and then go to the mound like they do in Little League. I'd love to see that at least one time.
All right, we'll try to do it. Hey, it might happen, because he's not the only one. Jake Ortega, a freshman who you probably don't know, he's another guy. He's a catcher, pitcher, infielder,
beautiful,
/ outfielder. So he's in the mix for some positions as well. So maybe we'll do it with Jake too.
We're just going to, the entire roster is going to, not instead of listening, infield, outfield, everyone's going to have a U by their name. Utility / pitcher.
And that's okay with me.
And that is fine. That is absolutely great. Some of the best players we've had in the program have done that. So a good fall all in all. You brought up the pitching a little bit, and that's one of the areas where lost a lot of starters, but also had some starters return that were very strong at the end of the year last year. So how do you kind of assess the pitching staff's performance in the fall?
I give them a B. A.J. Maneras was really good. He went out and pitched over the summer. He finished strong for us last year in the spring. Had some quality innings. He came in and pitched well, I thought. Steven G. is a right-handed pitcher who we're going to really rely on heavily. He did okay. He's working on some things. We would like Steven to develop a changeup and a better breaking ball, so he worked hard at that. Garrett Nimmo, a right-hander, junior right-hander, who had some quality innings for us last year. He has developed a really good hard-sinking fastball, so he's in the mix. Max Carter, who's pitched here for a couple of years, he pitched. He was Max. He threw a lot of strikes. He has a good changeup. We're trying to develop a breaking ball with Max. He needs another pitch if he's going to be a legitimate weekend starter. And then Andrew Hansen, a freshman out of Centennial High School, for me, showed really well. He was a three-pitch mix, nothing overpowering, but a lot of strikes, very athletic. Isaiah Moten, another rookie freshman, threw well, attacked the strike zone, and he was good. We got a junior college guy, Adam Coates, left-hander, who did not throw much this fall. He has a sore shoulder. We're hoping he can have an impact on the staff as well in the spring.
Awesome. Awesome. So a good fall together. And then yesterday the schedule comes out that you guys just released for 2016. Kind of starting with a home-and-home series to sort of start the year against Cal State Northridge. Obviously, always a challenge, challenging program there. And then some pretty good names coming to Hard Field, starting with, St. John's, that first kind of big three-day series.
Yes. Yeah, St. John's was the Big East champs last year. You might remember Creighton came in opening weekend and played awesome. They were outstanding. They really played well for three games coming out of the gym. I was really surprised and impressed with the type of player they had and the way they did play. And St. John's won that league, and they're coming in now. So we have the big second year in a row that we have the Big East champs. I believe Creighton might have been Big East champs. I'm not quite sure on that the year before. But anyway, St. John's historically has very strong pitching.
Yeah.
And they again, will have some arms. So that'll be an exciting series. And then we're looking forward to Oklahoma. The Sooners are coming to Bakersfield, which I think is really exciting. We play them on St. Paddy's Day, Thursday, Friday, and two games on Saturday.
Yeah, that'll be a that'll be a series that has a lot of – I think a lot of locals will be excited about that. I mean, let's be honest. This town was founded by people from Oklahoma, and there's tons of ties and families. I've got family members that are the same way. So I think you're gonna have a. I think that'll be a great. I think it'll be a great series. But I think you're gonna have a great turnout with the fans excited to see the Sooners in town and seeing how we do against them.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it. And I didn't know this when we scheduled them. See, originally it was scheduled in Oklahoma.
Right.
And the coach called me, and they're on break, and they wanted to come out here.
Okay.
So I said, let's go. They have the potential number one overall pick for the June 2016 draft coming in. So that's going to add another 50 people to the attendance, just the scouts alone. He's a these guys faced him 2 years ago when they went out to Oklahoma, and he's a legitimate up to 100 miles an hour with his fastball. So we certainly do have our hands full, but it'll be an exciting weekend to play them.
Absolutely. And then there's a couple other non-conference series, UC Riverside, and then a couple games here and there against UC Santa Barbara, some of the same midweek teams as we've seen in the past few years. Opening up WAC play at Seattle U on March 24th to 26th, kind of fitting that you will start up with the Red Hawks again after beating them in the WAC tournament last year.
Yeah, we'll get right into it right away. It'll turn into a bit of rivalry. I'm sure they're going to want to get after us, and we for sure want to get after them. Seattle has a really good team.
Yeah, a lot coming back, yeah.
Yes, they have some teams, and we have to go up there. So that'll, after our non-conference schedule, we'll be ready to take on the Red Hawks of Seattle.
Awesome. And then, again, hoping to, after the conference tournament sort of plays out, after the conference schedule plays out, hoping to be back in Holcomb Stadium once again in Mesa, Arizona, May 25th to the 29th for the WAC baseball tournament, looking to defend the title. So details on the schedule, and it's all posted right now online at GoRunners.com. I think the ticket folks are already ready to start rolling out season tickets as well. So Christmas presents, potentially, for folks as well, for baseball fans, and more details at GoRunners.com. One more thing I want to talk about, Coach, is the third annual Hot Stove Dinner coming up on Saturday, January 16th at the Kern County Fairgrounds, featuring Tommy Lasorda. Should be an interesting night for sure.
Yeah, I attended the one last year with Mike Socher, and I was really impressed. He honored us with he spoke to the team for 45 minutes, and I thought that was a great opportunity for the players to listen to Mike Socha. And then with Tommy Lasorda coming in, I know Mark Mays has worked really hard, and we're doing really well with the ticket sales. And that is just a really, really important and great night for CSUB athletics, and more specifically CSUB baseball. So I'm certainly looking forward to it. I know I would like to meet Tommy Lasorda and get to know him a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, he's an interesting speaker. Tommy likes to just yell. I'll be honest with you. Tommy just shouts. And so he's entertaining. I mean, still at like 80, whatever he is, something years old, he's still just yelling like you expect Tommy Lasorda to do it. So it's really good. He's seen everything there is to see in baseball. January 16th, individual tickets are $100, 654-3473. Give Mark Mays a call to this information's online at GoRunners.com as well. It's got some sponsorship opportunities as well if you want to get a table for nine. Also get to hang out with a coach or player at the table, and some special gifts as well from Roadrunner Baseball. Also have a table sponsorship for $1,000 and individual tickets for $100. It'll be at the Kern County Fairgrounds on January 16th, 5:30 p.m. I've spoken to Tommy a couple times back in my previous life doing sports talk radio, and both the times on the cell phone, so he's just yelling, and you ask him a question, and he just answers whatever he feels like he wants to answer at the time. It might be the question you ask. It might be something else that's on his mind. So, like I said, he is worth the price of admission, and a brilliant baseball mind. I know our friend George Culver has known Tommy forever, being in the Dodgers organization. He's got some great stories, too, so I can't wait to see what those guys come up with.
Yeah, it should be a great night, and we're looking forward to a really big turnout.
I know. George said one of his favorite things. He said when they used to have Dodger Town, when they used to do spring training in Vero Beach, he said Tommy had his own table. Even after he wasn't the manager anymore, Tommy had his own like table in the dining hall. And he said the day that Tommy like invited me to sit at his table and kind of get into his inner circle, he said that was like the greatest day of his life. Second, he said that was like acceptance in Dodger heaven, that Tommy Lasorda said, hey, have a seat, George. And then, you know, they went on to be great friends after that. So, again, that's coming up on January the 16th. Coach, enjoy a little time off right now. I know fall ball is over, but you guys, it's so crazy. Baseball starts in February, so we are just a few months out, and I can't wait to see it again. And enjoy your holidays, and we'll definitely be catching up with you come February time.
Thanks, Corey. Same to you.
All right, Coach Bob Macaluso here on Roadrunner Rundown. When we come back, speaking of CSUB baseball, one of our former Roadrunner hurlers turned knuckleball extraordinaire, Mickey Jannis, to join us on the phone. We'll chat with him fresh out of Arizona Fall League with the New York Mets. Back after this, it's Roadrunner Rundown.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders, from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to GoRunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to winning from those around us.
Our professors and peers.
Our coaches and teammates.
And our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they have inspired us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad. But did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian E-Edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, anyplace. Get your new Bakersfield Californian E-Edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
Roadrunners Basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSUB Basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE.
And welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. My thanks to Bob Macaluso, head baseball coach, joining us in the last segment. Also, Giovana Melo joined us on the program as well. Hey, we will be off next week because of holiday slash travel schedules and things like that. But be back in a couple weeks right here for another edition of Roadrunner Rundown. Well, a great story, and speaking of baseball, has been I always like seeing the stories of our alumni pop up and good things happening. And then the other day, after just kind of browsing the internet, something pops up from MLB.com about this fancy knuckleballer that the New York Mets have in their Arizona Fall League. And wouldn't you know, it's our very own Mickey Jannis, and he joins us on the phone now. Mickey, good to hear from you, man. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Good. Hey, congratulations on really your reinvention as a pitcher. I mean, it's been kind of a whirlwind for you, a couple years in independent ball after getting drafted by the Rays. But, wow, this thing's kind of worked out for you, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. It's been a long process over the last 4 or so years, but you know, wouldn't change anything that's happened, and you know, we'll see how far it takes me.
You know, I was asking you as soon as I saw that, you know, I know you'd been playing independent ball, and then I saw you with Long Island. Next thing you know, the Mets have signed you to a minor league deal, and it says knuckleballer. And I asked you the question on Facebook. I said, when did you become a knuckleballer? How'd that story kind of develop for you?
You know, it just kind of happened after I got released by the Rays in 2011. I almost threw a game with the Rays as a knuckleball pitcher, my last game with them in 2011. And, you know, the coaches liked what they saw, but I ended up not being able to throw in a game. And then I ended up getting released in the offseason. So kind of took it and was like, well, you know, why not give this a try to stand out in independent ball to get another shot at affiliated ball? Because, you know, I was just an average righty, you know, throwing 90 miles an hour from the right side, the slider, you know, nothing special. So kind of took it as like, you know, maybe somebody will take a chance on something different and standing out from the crowd.
Well, you know, the New York Mets obviously have a history in doing that, so kind of a perfect fit for you. But, I mean, independent ball, I mean, I know you were kind of bounced all over the place. I think, what, Michigan and then back east and Long Island, and you kind of been all over the map. But obviously you had to kind of have a mindset of seeing this thing through, because sometimes the road from independent ball to affiliated ball is kind of a tough one.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. You know, there's definitely some ups and downs, and times I struggled at times, and you know, I kind of stuck with it, and I knew deep down that, you know, what I was doing was good enough to get signed, and I think it was just a matter of time, because, you know, judging by, you know, my numbers and how I was getting guys out and stuff, I knew that as long as I kept doing that, you know, I'd give myself a chance.
And so obviously this,
you know, I kind of stuck with it, and, you know, finally paid off.
You know, obviously this is a pitch that you've kind of, I mean, most knuckleballers have this similar story to say, well, I would mess around and throw it once in a while. I mean, is that kind of how you were as well? You would just kind of throw it playing catch and decided, hey, I might have something in this thing.
Yeah, I threw it a little bit more, I would say. I threw it, you know, in summer ball here and there, you know. But, I mean, like you said, it's kind of on the side and not really something that you look forward to get drafted as. You know, so I know my catch partner at Cal State Bakersfield, he used to tell me, he's like, I'm not playing catch with you if you throw your knuckleball anymore. So I kind of had to stop throwing it. So, you know, I just kind of stuck with it on the side when I could, and, you know, had some fun with it with some guys who wanted to see it, and, you know, finally worked out for me.
What were the last, like, I don't know, what's it been, 6 months, 7 months or so, when you get signed out of Long Island to go back to the Mets organization and play in the minors, and then after that season's over, they tell you, hey, you want to go to the Arizona Fall League, and then that's where, you know, things kind of picked up for you. You know, MLB.com sort of picked up on you and showed your great numbers in the Fall League. What have these last few months been like for you?
It's just been crazy. The whole year's been crazy. bouncing around all over the place. And even before the season, you know, I went to one tryout and, you know, they didn't like me, but I knew, you know, like I said, if I stuck with it, you know, somebody would. And with the Ducks, you know, I kind of had to earn my way through the Ducks. You know, they're like, you know, we'll be five or six starter, you know, out of the bullpen, kind of in between. And then I kind of just kept pitching better and better and better. And they moved me to the rotation, and then the Mets saw me. And, you know, it's just been a crazy ride.
And a good one so far as well. What, you know, what did you take away from the fall league? I mean, obviously you got some pretty good attention there. So are you looking forward to what next season has in store for you in the Mets organization and where they might be sending you?
Oh, definitely. You know, I was made some good strides with the pitching coach and pitching coordinator down there. They're actually the pitching coordinator lives in Scottsdale, so he was fortunate enough to work with him while I was down there or down here, and you know, made some big strides with my mechanics and making sure those stay consistent and keep getting better, and you know, and just kind of waiting to see what happens next with the Mets. You know, just looking forward to some time off, but at the same time, you know, getting ready for spring training and see where I end up.
And on top of that, all as we pointed out, I know Coach Macaluso was just in here. He goes, "Hey, I think that Jannis guy threw against us in the alumni game." You know, you've got a chance to kind of follow this program and see how CSUB has developed from your, you know, being one of the originals on the 2009 squad and finishing up a 2010. What's it been for you, kind of being able to watch the Roadrunners have some success and winning the WAC and going into the regionals and getting a victory this past year?
Yeah, no, it's been awesome. You know, it's kind of the same thing that's happened to me. You know, it's just been a crazy long process that, you know, they had some success. I think it was 2011.
Yeah, right after you left,
their big year where they just missed their, just missed the regional in that one. And, you know, they finally got to one last year and played UCLA and played them tough. And, you know, unfortunate that they didn't get farther. But, you know, it's just hopefully the beginning of what the program becomes.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we're looking forward to seeing how your story continues to develop. Congratulations, really, on what's been a cool ride and just a great story. And we hope this thing pans out for you in the big leagues one day, because that'd be a heck of a story to tell. And another one of those awesome knuckleballer comebacks, and being one of our own, be even better. So, Mickey, enjoy a little bit of off time. I know you got to get back to work soon, and we'll be keeping tabs on you for sure. Thanks for joining us.
All right, no problem. Thanks for having me.
All right, Mickey Jannis here on Roadrunner Rundown. Graduated in 2010 from CSUB and then went on to a pretty good minor league career, but then got released. And, I think he played in Australia at one point. He went up north. I think he played down in Brisbane, won the Australian championship, and then played up north in Michigan and back east. And he was all over the map. And what do you know? He finally gets a shot, really a kind of a story of stick-with-it-ness as he gets a shot with the New York Mets organization, and should be interesting to see where they put him in the 2016 season as that gets going spring training here in a few months. So that's Mickey Jannis, and we'll have hopefully more on him as his story continues to develop. All right, folks, that'll do it for us this week. We're off next week, kind of a holiday travel situation thing, basketball as well on the road, so I'll be out. But we'll be back in a couple weeks here on Bakersfield.com and GoRunners.com as well, as we have all kinds of good stuff as the basketball season gets full throttle. We'll have that wrestling in action as well, and a lot of stuff to get to on the program. So we'll be back in 2 weeks here as we continue on Roadrunner Rundown. Get the show anytime online at GoRunners.com. Next week, if you're missing a show, just go back and watch all the other ones. GoRunners.com/rundown takes you right to the page. But you can maybe check out what you missed. If you actually missed it, you can check it out online on demand and get up to date on everything happening with CSUB Athletics. Follow us anytime online at GoRunners.com. Also, Facebook.com/CSUB Roadrunners and Instagram and Twitter at CSUB Athletics. You can also check us out on YouTube. You can follow a lot of our games there now as well at YouTube.com/CSUB Athletics. That'll do it for us this week, folks. And again, join us week after next as we're back live here on Roadrunner Rundown. Thanks to Bob Macaluso for joining us, head baseball coach, Giovana Melo, our director of volleyball, and of course, pitching alum Mickey Jannis, now with the New York Mets organization. We will catch you next time. Thanks once again. Have a happy Thanksgiving. This is Roadrunner Rundown.